Welcome to my final Lent devotion on this Maundy Thursday. Today we find ourselves with Jesus and his disciples at the Last Supper. The young servant was on hand to serve the meal, and this is his story. It was about a year ago when Jesus came to dinner with his disciples in my master's house. I was curious to see who this Jesus was who'd become so famous. Well, I can tell you this was no ordinary meal. Everyone had settled down and was eating together quite happily. Then all of a sudden, Jesus jumped up, took off his outer robe, and asked me for a towel and a basin of water. I wondered what this was all about, but as his servant, I quickly got him what he asked for. And then I watched him do something quite astonishing. He wrapped the towel around his waist, bent down, and washed the feet of his disciples, every single one of them. Now, you have to understand that this is the work of a slave, the lowliest servant in the house. No guest ever stoops down to do such a menial task. And here was Jesus, revered by his disciples as their Lord, doing the job of a lowly slave. I stood there, obedient but astonished. When Jesus was done, he handed me the bowl and the towel with a kind smile of thanks. And then he spoke. He declared that God was his Father who'd sent him into the world, but his mission was to be a servant, not a great king who lorded it over his subjects. He came as a humble servant who even stooped down to wash feet. But his task was far from menial. No, it was important, Jesus said. He spoke with great authority. He told his disciples that this is what they had to do too, to be servants to one another. I have given you an example, he told them, and you should do as I have done to you. I don't know if the disciples really understood what Jesus was saying, because he was really telling them to not just be servants to each other, but to everyone they met. That was a big ask. I certainly didn't understand until events soon unfolded. Then I learned that Jesus' life was all about service and sacrifice and salvation, and that he'd come to give his all for me and every one of us. But you'll learn more about that in the next few days. And now, may God bless you richly in your devotions today.